Is this you? You just came up with an amazing idea for your next coding project, but you have no idea where to start. Or you just got assigned your summer intern project and have no clue how you will meet your deadlines. This was definitely a challenge for me starting out. So in this video, I'll teach you all the tips and tricks I've learned to be able to turn my ideas into code. Whether you're a beginner or an experienced developer, I've got 5 steps that you can take to turn your ideas into reality. So let's dive right into it. The first step that you want to take is to define your problem clearly. You want to ask yourself, what does this problem solve? Who is it supposed to help? And what is the easiest way that you can actually achieve this? So if you want to build a to-do list app, you want to break it down. So you want users to be able to add notes, delete notes, edit notes, just simple concepts like that that you can actually work towards. One tip I can give you is to take your idea and try to break it down into one single sentence. This will help you stay focused on what matters the most in your project, and it'll help you figure out how you can get this done. So the next step you want to take is to break your idea down into smaller parts. You want them to be as manageable as possible. You can think about the features or the functions that you want your app to have and the different ways that you can achieve that. So for the example of our to-do list, you want to break that down into 3 simple steps. The first one would be the user interface. The second one would be all the data management. And the third one would be the ability to save and store the tasks. So the third step is arguably the most difficult, and it's determining which tools or technologies you want to use for your app. Whether you're doing something in front end, you want to use something like HTML, CSS, JavaScript. If it's something in the back end, maybe something like Python, Go, C++, or Java. And the difficult part about this is actually trying to figure out which technologies you need and which ones are just fluff that are adding extra complexity to your project. And if your project isn't too complex or difficult and people have done similar things before, you can just do a quick Google search or go on YouTube and find a similar project, so you won't spend too much time trying to figure out what's the best approach to your problem. So what I'd recommend is to start as small as possible. Think about what you need to get the project barely functional, and then code just that. This is called the MVP, or minimum viable product, and this is a great start to work towards your larger goals so that you don't start big and then mess up somewhere and then get burnt out. This can help prevent you from digging yourself into a hole where you're doing everything at once, and while trying to fix problems, you're causing new ones. So the 5th and final step that I have is to iterate and improve. You can have a friend or family member actually test your app and then figure out what works and what you want to change for the next release. By getting feedback earlier, you can prevent the snowballing effect where you have an issue or there's a portion of your product that the customer doesn't like, and then you end up developing on it, and then you find out in the end that no one actually wants to use it, and then you have to scrap the entire feature. So a recommendation that I'd like to give is to make sure that you're using some version control tool like Git. So you can save all your progress, and if there's an iteration that you actually want to go back and use, you can just do so. And that's about it. Turning your ideas into code doesn't have to be difficult. It's more about breaking it down and building it step by step. If you found this video helpful, make sure to hit the like button down below and subscribe for more coding content. And make sure to keep coding.